joined the Navy at 18. I went to boot camp, I went to A school, and I was attached to the USNS Comfort. I started having seizures at 19, and they gave me a medical discharge for my epilepsy. I was devastated. I didn't know what to do. My career had ended before it started. What do I do with my life now? And after that, I thought about kids.
It's important to think about women with epilepsy because women can get pregnant. So when we are treating women with epilepsy, the goal is to plan that pregnancy ahead of time.
Hello. Hi, Joanne. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. It's good to see you.
Number one, if you don't want to get pregnant, what type of birth control is the best that can work for you? Number two, if you want to get pregnant, let's establish a plan how we can get you ready for that pregnancy.
I think birth control is very important for a veteran who has epilepsy and she's in her reproductive years.
Birth control pills are indicated for women with epilepsy. However, these medications might have interactions with the anti-epileptic they are taking.
So I educate them on other forms of birth control. That way it doesn't affect the therapeutic level of the anti-epileptic medication. Those other forms can be condoms or the intrauterine devices.
Before I started seeing Dr. Lopez, I was under the impression that, you know, basically there was no hope.
I'm sort of worried because of the side effects, because my husband and I want to have a baby.
The medications that I was on, which were Depakote, has severe side effects on fetuses, and the baby could be born with, you know, malformations or spina bifida and all these other things that sound horrendous when you want to be a mom.
Women who are diagnosed with epilepsy, they might have the fear that they won't be able to have a normal baby or they might not be able to become pregnant.
So how long has it been since you had your last EEG?
Maybe about a year ago. At first, we were just trying to get my seizures under control. And we sort of got them better, not completely under control. And then I told her that my husband and I wanted to have babies. And she told me, don't worry about it, we could do this.
The ideal scenario is to have those patients seizure-free by the time they are ready to conceive. However, when that doesn't happen, and the patient really wants to get pregnant, we can move along trying to get that pregnancy as an option. But as you can imagine, that carries a risk.
The number one risk is if she has a seizure while, you know, she's in gestation, the fetus can suffer from hypoxia, meaning lack of oxygen. They also have risk factors of the baby having malformations. Most of the veterans with epilepsy are taking more than one medication. So the goal is to taper her down to just one medication at its lowest dose to prevent seizures and keep the baby from getting malformations.
Some of these women stop taking the anti-epileptic once they know that they are pregnant. And it's a huge mistake because the risk of having breakthrough seizures during the pregnancy is much higher than having side effects with that anti-epileptic that they are taking. Some women can have a type of epilepsy that is genetic. So what it means is that there is a possibility that the baby will have epilepsy at some given point in their development. There are other type of epilepsy syndromes that are not genetic, so the babies won't have epilepsy. Ideally, it would be better to have at least 6 months prior to getting pregnant to have a better control of those seizures. That time is very crucial because it will help the provider and the patient to establish the level of the anti-epileptic that is actually working for this patient, that is keeping her free, because that level is the same level that we need to achieve once they get pregnant.
I want to see you on a monthly basis. We want to monitor your seizure frequency.
Once the veteran finds out that she is pregnant, she will be making monthly visits to see her neurologist just to check the level of her anti-epileptic medication. They'll do blood work to check for folic acid or the levels of vitamin D, because some of the anti-epileptic medication causes deficiencies in these vitamins.
It's a very important thing to keep in communication with a head obstetrician. They need to be aware of the current medication they're taking, the screening that these patients need to have to detect malformations. This type of population of women with epilepsy might be better off being taken care of by an obstetrician who is specialized in high-risk pregnancies. Women with epilepsy can have a normal vaginal delivery. Interestingly though, they do have a higher number of C-sections. Once the baby is delivered, we start tapering down the medication so the patient doesn't have any toxicity or toxic side effects. Most of the anti-epileptics that are used right now are okay to be used when the woman is lactating the baby. Some anti-epileptics may cause sedation, so it is important to monitor the baby that they don't get sleepy, but they can breastfeed. When women reach menopause, seizures can go in different ways. 30% of the seizures can get better, 30% seizures can get worse, and 30% of them are not going to change. Also, it's important to know that the hormonal replacement pills are contraindicated in women with epilepsy, especially if they are smokers, because that carries several risks. Number one, seizures can get worse because the estrogen is higher. And number two, they might have risk of having strokes. So it is important to counsel the patients about the effect of these anti-epileptics in bone health. The key of that is working before the problems occur instead of treating osteoporosis.
I had a suspicion, and so I took a pregnancy test. And when it came back positive, I took three more. And they all came back positive.
And I'm sitting down on a Saturday, and out of nowhere, my sister comes in with a big cookie, and she goes, "You're gonna be a father." I'm like, "No way."
And I was excited at first, then I got nervous, then all I wanted to do was see my doctor.
She was so thrilled, and the thing that she said is, "Guess what, Dr. Lopez?" Those were her eyes. And she gave me a hug. And we didn't need to say anything. Now we got there, let's move along and make sure that this goes smooth.
I had a perfect pregnancy. No seizures, any kind of seizures. It was perfect. I couldn't have asked for better. I had to see the doctor every month since it was considered a high-risk pregnancy. I had a sonogram every month. They did extra blood work. Every month I had to have blood work in order to see the levels of my medication. We had to up the dose every month. In the sonograms, they would never see any defects, any stress upon the baby, and I was 100% fine. I was not able to carry the baby to term. I spent 8 months of a perfect pregnancy. And then all of a sudden, I had high blood pressure. The doctor wanted a C-section in order not to stress me out because he didn't want me to have a seizure while I was giving birth. My son is a very happy kid. He loves to smile. He is very active. And besides that, he's like any normal two-year-old.
He's crazy. He tells me what to do. He tells me no, he tells me yes, he come here, milk. He tells me what to do, and you can be dead tired. Once you come into the door, you're not tired anymore. He tells you, "Poppy," and you're happy, and he gives you a kiss, and he goes, "I love you." It's beautiful.
Being a mom is what I always wanted. I am grateful to Dr. Lopez that everything came out great.
I think even the word of joy or happiness is not good enough to describe how she feels. She feels like a whole person, complete human being, a mom, a caregiver. She felt that nothing is left out.
I would tell other women veterans who want to have kids that it is possible. You research, you take your time, you listen to your doctors, and you do what you have to do. And you can do it.
My advice is do not give up. Fulfill your dreams and keep working on it because it's worth it.